Hello class. Today we're going to learn how to write letters giving news and information. This type of letter is very popular and it's very useful. First, I'm going to tell you the main point to be covered in this lesson. To learn this lesson well, you need to master the feature of letters giving news. I'm going to show you the sample task and answer so that you can learn more from task recognition and also the sample to help you perform your letter well. We also have a look at paragraph plan. This one will enable you to write professionally. Most importantly, I'm going to highlight and tell you more about the use of language and expression, useful and typical for this kind of letters. In this lesson, I'm going to give you some guidelines and advice, some tips so that you can do the practice. And also, I give you some direction on your writing assignment. Let's begin with the feature of letters giving news. The purpose of the card letter is to give information, usually when this has been requested by someone else. As for the contents, this card letter mainly provide news and information. Sometimes you may need to make suggestion, offer help, or give your opinion. Whether you give a specific piece of information, it depends on the writing task, and in reality, it depends on the communication situation or the request from someone else. For text organization, you need to master that in professional writing. We discuss each point in a separate paragraph. And within paragraph, usually we begin with a clear topic sentence. And for the main part of the paragraph, we provide details, examples, or justification. In terms of writing style, this card letter can be written as informal or formal letter. It's related to a particular situation. As I have told you several times before, writing informal letter is quite easy because you can write it using spoken language that is very familiar to most of us. However, it is much harder to write in formal style. Therefore, the main part of my lecture will help you to write formal letter so that you can apply it to your reality when you write on behalf of your company or your businesses. Please have a look at this sample writing task. As the university accommodation officer, you have received a letter requesting information. Write a letter in reply, including details of the available housing facilities, the amenities provided, location, transportation, facilities, and rent cost. Please pay attention to the task word. Write a letter, include detail of. Whenever you receive some writing task with such task, write letter, including detail of something, they indicate giving news and information. Please pay attention because in your final examination and in the examination room, the writing task, you never say very explicitly or clearly that you have to write giving news or application letter. No, you need to be able to analyze the task and you can look at the key words in the instruction of the task so that you will know that these keywords of the task tell you what kind of letter you need to write. And now, please have a look at the letter. And this letter is written in formal style. First, you can see we need to have a suitable reading. And then you write one or two sentences stating the purpose or the reason for writing the letter. This one should be concise. The next paragraph, you provide the detail, but you should divide it into separate paragraphs, and each paragraph here will deal with one main aspect or one main point. At the end of the letter, usually we have the closing remarks, and you should express your final closings correctly. Remember to sign your name and write your full name. Altogether, you can see this letter contains paragraph 1, paragraph 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 paragraph. Not every letter contains 6 paragraph. You may write from 4 to 6 paragraph. It depends on the requirements of your writing task. In this kind of letter, it's also very helpful for you to notice some typical expression. Look at this one, you can see we have the word has something. It's not provided, to be provided, to be available, to be situated. This one is you when you want to mention the location of something, or you can use to be restricted. This means this one is not available or is limited to a certain person or things. You can use range from or vary from when you mention the range of prices. These are very important expressions that you need to learn by heart and to use properly in your letter. And you also need to learn the word in blue. These words are called transitional signal, to have you link the idea and make your writing sound coherent and it goes smoothly. All right, so these words can appear in every letter where necessary. Now, we will look at the paragraph plan in more detail. For paragraph one, usually we say the purpose or the reasons for writing the letter. The body paragraph We give information as required. And in the next paragraph, you can provide further explanation, suggestion, or opinion as stated in the task instruction. And the final paragraph, the closing remark, your full name, and remember that the exact number and division of paragraph, for example, you write 4 paragraphs or 5 paragraphs, it depends on the instruction for the writing tasks. As I have told you, for specific high up letter, we need to learn by heart and to write exactly some typical structure or language for that kind of writing. In writing letters giving news, we usually begin the letter with some phrases like this. I'm writing to inform you that, to advise you of something, to let you know that. And remember, in friendly letter, informal letters, we use to let you know that. The other ones are used for formal letter. Or you can start the letter with some other phrases, such as, I'm delighted to inform you, I would like, or in informal style, we write, I'd like to inform you. And if you think that's okay, something that you have to do as your duty or your responsibility, you can use, I feel obliged to inform you. This one is very formal and for business letter. You should also learn the other phrases, such as, I'm writing in response to, but we write with regard to, or in connection with. Please pay attention to the collocation of the expression in response to, but with regard to. But which is in connection with, so please be accurate. Now, please have a look at the example. I'm writing in response to your request for information regarding university accommodation. So you can see in this 31st sentence of the letter, we tell the reader about the purpose and the topic. We mention the topic, giving information. And then you can write, I have included details of your accommodation in general, as well as public describing the individual course of residence. Okay, so the first paragraph will be writing, and the main aspect of information that you are going to provide that. It depends on situation, so that you can provide various pieces of information. Sometimes you need to give a direction or location. So you can think of some expressions such as to be situated, to be located at or in. So whether you at or in, it depends on the name or on the grammar of that sentence. For example, you can say, the halls are mostly situated in residential area. In many other cases, you may need to inform other people about facilities or services. Here are some important verbs. For example, to have. It's very simple, but it's very useful. Sometimes you can use contain or to be equipped with. With you to be equipped with, when you mention the devices, equipment, furniture. I'm going to illustrate with two examples. First one, President have a laundry load and some board prior in his drive center contains a waste room and swimming pool. Another very useful expression that you should learn is to be available or to be provided with. For example, university accommodation is available in the form of private flats and house. Now we learn more with giving information about pricing. So you can say the price or the cost range from to. You can say vary from to. Or you can use very simply with the verb to cost. For example, you can say the computer costs $50. Okay, so you can take cost as we have learned so far. Now look at the example. Accommodation range catering, so $75 per week for room with an in-suite bathroom and food board. All right, and in this sentence, please pay attention to this where many of you may pronounce this one incorrectly. You can say suit. No, we say this one sweet, sweet. It looks like candy. We say sweet, not suit. So remember how to pronounce this word. Sometimes you may need to inform your receiver the restriction or unavailable service, and you may use some structure like to be restricted, to be not provided, or to be extra. There are two examples. Access to these facilities is restricted those to protect playing services. Or the price includes travel and accommodation, but meals are extra. So this one means that meals are not free, but you need to pay money. But the other services are free. All right, so I have told you and happy to learn some more very useful impressions in letters, TV news, and information. To end the letter, you may need to signal with closing remarks such as I trust or I hope that this information will be of some assistance. Or I hope that I have been able to answer all your questions. This one, in response to the previous letter that your partner would like you to provide them with some information that they need. Or you can say, I would be pleased or happy to provide you with any additional information. I want to show that you are willing to provide help for other people if they need more information. The final closing remark, you can say, I look forward to being able to help you again in the future, or I look forward to answering your queries. Or, should you require further information, please do not hesitate to contact me. For example, this is taken from a formal letter. I trust this information will be of some assistance, and I look forward to meeting you in September when term start. I have enclosed accommodation form for you to complete. Please do not hesitate to contact me should you require any further information. We use this one for business letter. If you need to practice of your own with complete letter, look at this writing assignment one. You should spend about 20 minutes on this task. You are the training director for a large international company and you are organizing a two-day training course for senior staff. You have invited Professor William Jones, a leading expert on industrial relations, to take part in the course as a guest lecturer. Write a letter to Professor Jones, giving details of the training and social activities which have been planned for the course and confirming the arrangements you have made for him concerning transport and accommodation. You should write between 200 and 300 words. So this is a formal letter. When you write a letter, you should pay attention to how many aspects or main pieces of information that you need to cover. So look at this one. The first one is just the warming up or the leading information. So here you're going to provide the training, number one, training activity, social activity, aspecto, and confirm the arrangement for transport, three, an arrangement for accommodation, four. All right, so you may need to write four body paragraph with the introduction and the ending paragraph. So you may need to write 5 to 6 paragraphs for this letter. And now, some guidelines for writing assignment two. You should spend about 20 minutes on this task. Remember, in examination, you should spend 20 minutes. So you should practice writing very quickly. And if you want to write quickly, you need to master the paragraph plan and also to learn by heart so that you can use the different expression where appropriate. You are organizing a conference and are in charge of informing participants of the time and place. You should also include details of the schedule and plan activities as well as the subjects to be discussed. Write a letter to send to the participant. You should write between 200 and 300 words. Thank you and see you next meeting. Các bạn để tài liệu của mình ra. Okay, and now I'm showing you exercise one. So can you look at your material? Help me to read aloud the instruction and question A to question G in your material. Okay, please.
Exercise one, read the following questions, then listen to the dialogue and answer them. A, why hasn't Steve written earlier? B, what does he think of Hong Kong? C, what is the weather like? D, what happened to him recently? E, what does he say about his new colleges? F, is his new job easier than the one he has in London? G, how does the writer feel about his new situation?
Quite good, thank you. I remember to say this place name correctly. We don't say Hong Kong, it sounds like Vietnamese. We say Hong Kong. And for the word one, we say colleagues. And the final sound is the. All right, so just pay attention to some pronunciation. To answer this exercise, you need to access the audio to listen. And the audio has been provided for you and shared to you on your online course. So you are supposed to listen and do this at home before attending this meeting. However, if you are not very confident So this one, you can access your e-learning course, listen to it one more time and answer this question. For example, in A, you can write short answers again like this one. Because he has been extremely busy. That's why he hasn't written earlier. And please answer the other question. So remember, we should also listen and to practice on your listen. And through your listen, you can also learn some more language and vocabulary useful for the letter. Okay, I'm going to give you some guide for all the exercises so that you can prepare in a few minutes. This one is instruction for exercise 2. So can you help me to study the instruction from the English?
Dạ, em đây thầy ơi.
All right.
Thầy là đọc hay sao ạ?
Nãy giờ thầy nói rõ ràng thế mà không biết thì làm sao. Vài đứa đi ra trường á, như Pháp vậy đó. Sau họ nói xong là mình biết là mình làm cái gì chứ.
Thầy, nhưng mà ấy là cái mạng của thầy. Cái mạng của thầy nó bị giật giật á. Em nghe cứ tiếng được tiếng mất lại hình là chạy nhưng mà không nghe được tiếng rõ.
À, vậy thì có thể là không phải là mạng là của thầy đâu. Vì các bạn khác vẫn có thể là nghe rõ. Do này chúng ta không biết là điều kiện ở đâu. Thì bây giờ em thầy thấy là em nghe rất là rõ mà phản hồi thầy rất là nhanh mà. Bây giờ mà em rồi giờ đọc lại hướng dẫn bài đi.
Đọc hết rồi. Dạ, exercise 2. Read the following letter and correct the mistake. Write it S for spelling, B for punctuation, W O for word order, Z for grammar and W for wrong word.
Alright, đọc lại tên này cho đúng nè. Punctuation tức là chấm phẩy dấu câu.
Dạ.
Không là phân một punctuation.
Dạ.
Say again.
Punctuation.
Phân một lời. Anh đọc không? Punctuation.
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 Qua cái phần các em làm hoạt động này thì mình học nó tăng cường kỹ năng nói và phát âm rồi nữa, và đồng thời qua đó các em hiểu hướng dẫn làm bài năng nói cái gì để sau đó chúng ta cập nhật nó hơn. Alright, so I'm going to give you some guide on how to do this one. For example, with the word many, you should comment that this is grammar. How about the next word, visiting Kenya? So this one is spelling. It means it's wrong in spelling. Visiting only one T, not double T and E. Right, so do the other one. So we have many. Actually, the first part. All right, and exercise 2. Put the verbs in practice into past simple or present perfect. All right, for example here, arrive, we say done. Arrive done, because 2 days ago, so you should use with simple past tense. How about the other one? So can you complete this? Exercise 4, this one is in the form of a letter, dear chairman, etc. And this one is the letter, the writer provides some news in the form of telling his story. Okay, so number one told. How about the other gaps? By the way, I would like to tell you that we are writing letters level C, so it requires accuracy. Nhân tiện, thầy lưu ý các bạn về đặc điểm chương trình cấp độ C của mình. Tên gọi của khoa học chúng ta là viết C1.2. Đó là chúng ta đang ở cấp độ C1 theo chuẩn châu Âu. Theo thang trình độ tiếng Anh chuẩn châu Âu, cấp độ cao nhất là cấp độ C2, thì chúng ta là C1, là cấp độ gần như là maximum rồi. Do đó các bạn nếu mà so sánh các lá thư thì đề nghị các bạn tuyệt đối không nên chủ quan, mà em nên lấy lại các sách trước đây mình học, em đối chiếu các bức thư, vì thư nó cùng một loại. Trước đây chúng ta cũng học là application letter này, chúng ta cũng học là request letter này, nhưng mà em phải để ý cùng dạng bức thư nhưng kiểu viết của cấp độ C1 nó dài lắm và cái độ khó của nó cao hơn. Đặc biệt khi các em viết cùng loại lá thư nhưng trước đây chúng ta sai về những chia động từ, chia thì, dùng sai liên từ, thì người ta trừ điểm theo cái số lượng từ mà chúng ta sai. Như ở cấp độ C1 thì người ta không chấm theo cách đó, mà người ta chấm theo thang độ, có nghĩa là động từ mà chia sai có nghĩa là bạn chưa vượt qua cấp độ A2, vì cấp độ A2 tiếng Anh là cấp độ biết chia động từ rồi. Cho vậy những bạn nào mà viết một bức thư chúng ta sai ở phần động từ rồi phần thì thì điểm của chúng ta người ta sẽ kê là điểm A2, có nghĩa là nó tương ứng với thang điểm 3 điểm rưỡi cho đến 4 điểm. Do vậy các bạn phải chú ý, chứ không phải như em thường suy nghĩ là thì em sai 5 từ thì người ta nhân lên 5 từ sai, mà khác thì sai 7 từ thì nhân lên 7 từ người ta trừ điểm tương ứng. Nó không phải vậy các bạn. Có bạn sai 5 từ nhưng bị trừ điểm ít hơn một bạn sai có 2 từ thôi. Ví dụ như có một số bạn sai rất ít, nhưng mà cái sai của em là sai có 2 từ nhưng mà rơi vào cái phần chia động từ, thì giám khảo người ta sẽ phê rằng là thí sinh này không chia động từ được và đang nằm ở cấp độ là A2 tiếng Anh. Như vậy cực kỳ tai hại luôn. Chúng ta chỉ còn có 3 điểm rưỡi cho đến 4. Còn có bạn sai có hồi 5, 7 từ, 10 từ, sai đỏ vậy đó, nhưng mà cái sai của họ là nó không phải sai ở cái hạ cái cấp độ. Chẳng hạn như họ sai là họ dùng cái từ đó nó quá mức độ, hay là nó chính xác một tí thì nó bị trừ điểm ở cái mức độ khác. Đó là lý do vì sao thầy đề nghị các em gặp những dạng bài tập này tuyệt đối đừng có nghĩ rằng là nó giống như dạng bài tập chia động từ hồi mình học lớp 9. Mình học cấp 3 là mình chia động từ hoài, mình chia thì hoài rồi. Bây giờ chắc là nó cũng dễ, mình không có cần làm đâu. Hay là tại sao là bữa nay họ đưa cho mình làm? Bởi vì nếu chúng ta làm sai, làm sai một chỗ người ta sẽ nghĩ chúng ta đó là mình lơ đễnh, mình bị mistake. Nhưng bắt đầu sai từ hai chỗ mà cùng trù, như cùng ở chi thì người ta hạ cái band của mình xuống, hạ cái giải điểm của mình xuống liền. Như vậy là thầy cũng dành thời gian ý nghĩa lưu ý lại cho các em về yêu cầu của cấp độ viết C2, nó rất khác so với tất cả các yêu cầu trước đây của mình. Exercise 5. I'd like to invite Phù Chi Huân.
Dạ.
So happy to allow the instruction and the underline phrase. Em đọc hướng dẫn làm bài mà những cục được gạch dưới thôi. Còn những cái chỗ khác thì các em xem chi tiết trong tài liệu của mình.
Yeah.
Now please.
Read the following letter and replace the underlined verbal phrase with more appropriate informal ones. I feel obligated to write to inform. Please accept my sincere apologies for not writing. Suitable opportunity. Have become familiar with improving considerably. I hope to return. I look forward to hearing from you soon. Yours sincerely.
We say sincerely. With this, we say sincerely. All right. So pay attention to pronounce this word. All right. You can see this letter is formal. It's a very formal. But here you're writing to your mom, so it should be informal. Therefore, you can change some formal phrase into informal ones. I'm going to do the first one for you, example. For example, instead of saying, I felt obliged to write to inform you, So you should think, so I just have to write and tell you. Okay? So it sounds more suitable. How about the other one? So please be there to change it. Okay, and exercise 6. Lê Thị Thu Trang, please.
Dạ có em ạ.
Good. Say aloud instruction and topic 1.
Write these letters in the appropriate style using 120 to 130 words. 1. Last week, your colleague at the office threw a surprise party to celebrate your promotion. Write a letter to a friend telling him or her about the party.
Yes, all right. You can see this letter a bit general. I just ask you, write a letter to a friend telling him or her about the party. So you should design or think of paragraph plan. As usual, paragraph 1, we write the reason for writing. So you can mention what happened last week. In paragraph 2 or 3, you give the detail about the party. For example, you should write the time, how many, about the food, about the music, what other activity, for example, dancing, singing, karaoke, or whatever, all right? So you should divide in separate paragraph, the closing remark. You can add some suitable remarks. For example, you can write, off your well. But you need to add more. So this one is for you to add more idea to prepare so that you can write this letter well. With this one, we have task 2. And I would like to invite Đỗ Kiều Diễm.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. So allow us to.
You have been on holiday abroad for a week. Write a letter to your parents describing your holiday so far.
Thank you. I have just given you some idea for making suitable paragraph plan for a particular writing task. So now do the same. What idea you will prepare, what you will write in each paragraph for this writing task. So prepare now. Okay, and now time for you to update the answer. By the way, we also have a 15-minute break. So altogether, we have a 15-minute break plus 10 minutes for you to update the answer. Các em lưu ý là theo yêu cầu của chương trình và điều này đã được nêu trong syllabus cũng như trong buổi học đầu tiên, các bài tập cơ bản. Còn các bài tập mà các em nộp sẽ là bài tập gọi là trọn vẹn. Mình tự viết từ đầu cho đến cuối luôn. Còn cái bài tập này là bài tập của này cơ bản là mọi người phải làm được thì sau đó mới viết hoàn chỉnh được. Thì những bài tập này các bạn làm sẵn ở nhà rồi. Còn lên đây á, vừa rồi chúng ta vừa mới review để các em được có môi trường luyện thêm về tiếng Anh, học thêm những kỹ năng khác và đặc biệt là chúng ta share để các bạn cập nhật. Cho nên các bạn phải hiểu chứ đừng hôm sau đó là 10 phút thì không đủ thời gian cho em. 10 phút đây là không phải là 10 phút để mình làm từ đầu đến cuối, mà 10 phút là các em đã làm trước rồi. Bây giờ chúng ta dựa vào phần bài giảng lúc trước và phần hướng dẫn vừa rồi để chúng ta cập nhật lại thôi. Như vậy là các em có 10 phút. Như vậy tổng cộng chúng ta sẽ có 25 phút. Như vậy các em cũng nên sử dụng thời gian cho hợp lý. Nghỉ 15 phút, tập thể dục, rồi uống nước gì đó cho thư giãn. Sau đó vô chúng ta chỉnh sửa lại khoảng 10 phút. Và chúng ta sẽ gặp lại